This may look like your average cycling class, but it's not. And what you can't see in the studio are the hundreds of riders who are joining in from home.
Last one, I need you to be magical. Saddle down.
Peloton is one of many companies disrupting the fitness industry. From Daily Burn to CrossFit to ClassPass, fitness is becoming more about on-demand and all-access. There's an increasing number of workout companies using technology to offer members unlimited streaming workouts that lets users take all kinds of classes from different locations or in the convenience and privacy of their homes. Peloton co-founder and CEO John Foley likens it to people wanting things on their terms, their time, and with more convenience.
Going back to when you and I grew up and there were 13 channels and at 8 o'clock you had to be there for Magnum PI, now with Netflix and with all these other video streaming apps, you can watch content and consume content where you are, when you want. So I think fitness is the next frontier of that, and I think Peloton is going to help pioneer it.
Today, some $26 billion is spent annually in the U.S. on fitness. Digital workouts are slowly taking a chunk out of that number. On-demand fitness services jumped to nearly 8% of total spending on workouts last year, up from nearly 5% in 2014. At Peloton alone, sales more than doubled from 2015 to 2016. The company made $170 million in revenues last year, nearly three times as much as the year before. Foley, who founded Peloton in 2012, after everyday life got in the way of he and his wife's workouts, hopes 2017 will be the company's first profitable year.
How do you see yourself? Is it an application? Is it fitness equipment? Is it technology?
At our core, we are an innovation company and a technology company, full stop.
Where's the health or the fitness?
Yeah, I mean, certainly we're in the fitness category, and we're the first, I believe, hardcore technology shop to enter the fitness category. We certainly aren't a stationary bike company by any stretch.
Yet Peloton does sell its own stationary bike that lets users tap into live studio classes or a library of 3,000 cycling and other workout offerings at any time of the day in the privacy of their own homes.
How many bike owners do you have?
So we're approaching 100,000 bikes in the market.
Okay. Is that globally?
That's effectively globally. We sell domestically, but people have taken them to 26 countries. So we have bikes all over the world, but we right now are focused on selling the bikes in the States.
What's the most usage? Because there's rides where you can be over in Europe riding, or you can be part of a live class, or you can download, you know, there's a whole menu of different types of classes that you
can download.
I'm just curious, what gets the most use?
Yeah, so interestingly, only 20% of the rides taken are live. I think the live experience is so much more fun because the energy is like live music. You're there, and if you know Carol, they'll actually give you a shout out. They'll break the fourth wall, look in the camera and say, Carol in Jersey City, it's your 100th ride, you're gonna pull us up the next hill. And it's very immersive. You're part of the theatrics and the entertainment for a live class. On demand is 80% of the rides. Mm-hmm. And what it kind of tells you is that people really care about having their instructor and their time and controlling that environment versus being driven by our schedule of the live rides.
Have your own stationary bike and still want access to Peloton classes at home? There's a Peloton app for that.
You know, you mentioned technology innovation company. Who do you see as your competition? Is it SoulCycle? Is it Flywheel? Is it ClassPass? Is it?
No, we're rooting for the category. We love SoulCycle. We love Barry's Bootcamp. We love Flywheel. We love yoga. You know, we're trying to be good in the fitness category. So to your question, who do we see as our competitors? What keeps me up at night is if Apple or Google or Amazon were to enter our category. Those are the only three companies that I believe have the tech resources and the tech chops to give us a run for our money.
IPO this year?
No.
Because?
We are looking to do a fundraise in the next couple months that would allow us to be as aggressive as we want and take our time considering the public markets.
Next year, maybe?
Maybe.
Maybe. Because I've read something about a $10 billion valuation in 5 years. Is that real?
I would be disappointed if it weren't real. I think that certainly starts to be in the order of magnitude of what we're seeing as the opportunity here. I think that's on the low side of where we see this business going in the next 5 or 10 years.
This April, the monthly subscription service app ClassPass, which grants users access to thousands of different workout classes around the world, plans on rolling out its own video on demand feature, joining companies like Daily Burn and Beachbody On Demand, which have been offering streaming since 2015. And while currently only 15% of fitness consumers are working out on demand, Dana Mackey at market research company Mintel doesn't expect it to stay that way.
In 5 or 10 years, we'll definitely see digital fitness trend continue to grow. I think the new entrants to the market will be more in tune with new technologies, including augmented and virtual reality.
I think Americans are living busier and busier lives, so they want things to work into their schedules and work into their locations versus having to go somewhere at somebody else's schedule. I think that's a dated concept.